Thank you. say the words I never say. Looking like a beautiful day. Someone tell me how I feel. So here on board Vivian Drive. Oh, kiss me like a final meal. Yeah, kiss me like we died tonight. Laugh politely at repeats. Yeah, kiss me when my lips are thin. Cause holy cow. Looking like a beautiful day.
running out of ways to make you see. I want you to stay here beside me. I won't be okay and I won't pretend I are. So just tell me today and take my heart. Please take my heart. Please take my heart. Please take my heart. This was all I wanted, all I want. It's all I want. It's all I want. It's all I want. It's all I want. Just say yes. Just say there's nothing. Nor a trick of the mind, only love. Just say yes, 'cause I'm aching. I know you are too. For the touch of your warm skin as I breathe you in.
Morning has broken. We have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Ollie and Katie, to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will, to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life, created and hallowed by God, that Ollie and Katie are now to begin. They will each give their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows, and in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Fantastic. Katie and Ollie, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Oliver James, will you take Katie Elizabeth to be your wife?
I will.
Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Katie Elizabeth, will you take Oliver James to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And a question for everybody. Will you, the families and friends of Ollie and Katie, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Ollie and Katie, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
We'll now have our readings.
Corinthians 13. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I'm only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonour others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered.
It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now, we see only a reflection, as in a mirror. When we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Love is a temporary madness. It erupts like an earthquake and then subsides. And when it subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots have become so entwined together that it is inconceivable that you should ever part. Because this is what love is. Love is not breathlessness. It is not excitement. It is not the promulgation of promises of eternal passion. That is just being in love, which any of us can convince ourselves we are. Love itself is what is left over when being in love has burned away. And this is both an art and a fortunate accident. Your mother and I had it. We had roots that grew towards each other underground. And when all the pretty blossom had fallen from our branches, we found that we were one tree and not two.
I'm not sure whether any of you are a fan of romantic comedies, but I once lived with someone who was a huge fan. And the plot mostly seems to go as follows. Boy meets girl. Boy and girl like each other and begin dating. Boy upsets girl. Girl dumps boy. Girl spends time partying with female friends and decides she does not need boy. Boy pulls off some huge romantic gesture and girl forgives him. Boy and girl realize they are meant for each other. And at the end, there is a wedding. But in the church, we tell a slightly different story to your average romantic comedy, because we believe that a wedding is not the ending of a story, but the beginning of a story. Ollie and Katie are committing today to a life together out of their love for one another and making a new beginning starting on this day. The decision to get married doesn't come out of superficial or fleeting feelings, but out of a love that has become so precious that they cannot imagine being apart. St. Paul wrote the reading from the Bible that we've just heard, and he speaks very highly of genuine love. He's not just speaking of romantic love, but of all loving relationships. He says it's more important than being able to speak in the language of angels, more important than understanding all mysteries and having all knowledge, more important than having faith enough to move mountains, and more important than being generous enough to give up all your possessions. Loving another person makes us a better person, as does being truly loved by another. And that is why it's valued so highly in all sorts of religions and also in society in general. However valuable though it may be, love is not always easy. And sometimes it's incredibly hard. In marriage, joys are shared, but so are sorrows. Persistence and patience will be required at difficult times. And in the many seasons of life, both partners must try to love to the best of their ability. I recently met a couple who had been married 7 years, and their story really stuck in my mind, not only because they seemed so very happy, but also because I noticed the passage that has just been read was framed and on their living room wall. They both learned the passage off by heart and used it as a guide for how to love one another. I think it's a good guide for how to love because feelings aren't mentioned in that reading. It's all about actions, being patient, being kind, not insisting on your own way, putting the other before yourself. Sometimes, and hopefully a lot of times, those things come easily. But sometimes we have to make a conscious decision to treat the other person in a loving way. You're about to make vows in front of your family and friends to be in this relationship all your lives and to love one another all your lives. And they have just promised to support and uphold you in that relationship. And I pray and hope that there will be a strong and supportive network around your relationship. But your vows are also made in front of God. Today you're inviting God to be in a central place in your relationship. Love is God's very nature, so he honours and blesses the commitment that you made today, the lifelong promise to love one another and to be faithful to one another. And so we pray with you today that your love will bear all things, believe all things, hope all things, and endure all things, and that you may be happy together until the end of your lives. Who brings this woman to be married to this man? Holly and Katie, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. I, Oliver James.
I, Oliver James.
Take you, Katie Elizabeth.
Take you, Katie Elizabeth.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
I, Katie Elizabeth.
I, Katie Elizabeth.
Take you, Oliver James.
Take you, Oliver James.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Could I please have the rings? Is there a prayer of blessing over the rings? Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Ollie and Katie a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Katie Elizabeth, I give you this ring.
Katie Elizabeth, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
My body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Oliver James, I give you this ring.
Oliver James, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Ollie and Katie have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Olling and Katie in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, so that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. We now stand to sing our second hymn, Jerusalem.
Thank you.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we lift up our hearts to you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him you have made a covenant of grace with your people by the outpouring of your Holy Spirit. We praise you for the gift of marriage, in which the love of husband and wife reveals your purposes of love for the world. We thank you today for Katie and Ollie, for leading them to each other in friendship and love, commitment and trust, and for bringing them here for the blessing of their marriage. Living God, by the presence of your Holy Spirit, may they know the risen Christ to be with them now as they celebrate this covenant together. May their lives be a witness to your saving love in this troubled world. As you pour out your love, may they grow together in your sight and be to each other a companion in joy, a comfort in sorrow, and a strength in need. As you bless the earthly home of Nazareth with the presence of your Son, may their home be a place of security and peace. Bless this couple with the gift and care of children, that they may grow up to know and love you in your Son. As we celebrate the journey together of Ollie and Katie, we remember those whom we love but see no longer, especially remembering Katie and Ollie's grandparents, Ethel and Bert, Molly, Joseph and Sydney, Harold and Reedy. And bring us all at the last to that great marriage banquet of your Son in our home in heaven, where with all your saints and angels in the glory of your presence will forever praise you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Well, Katie and Ollie are now married in the eyes of God, but we have to now do the legal bit. So with those who are joining us in the signing of the register, please make their way to the Epiphany Chapel.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for your bride and groom?
There's somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue, or even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be mean, might never be cross or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do. For nobody else gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still. It had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you.
If there's somebody what you want to say, and you know the way you want to say it. You'll be so high, you'll be flying. I was her, she was me.
misses.
Woo! Yeah. Yeah.
They've come over from Edmonton, Alberta, which is our second home. And we've also got Donna and Brian from Kelowna. Excuse me, cut that. We've got Nora and Arlette who travel from Malta. Woo! How do you go back? I can't see you. Okay. Thanks for coming. And I'd like to extend a special welcome to Germain, who's come from Bayreuth. I was going to do a little French. Bienvenue, Germain. But he called me out to him. He's And also, I think he came to see Joby, actually. He didn't come for the He just came to give a job. Well, I'd like to thank everybody for making the effort. You all look absolutely gorgeous, and I hope you're enjoying yourselves as much as we're enjoying ourselves. It's a good day. There's a number of people I'd like to mention. For one reason or another, they couldn't be here. Ollie's aunties and uncles, Tub and Jeff, Dot and Lewis, Ollie's cousin Adele and Johnny, and the baby Jack in New Zealand. Also, Kate's cousin Stephen, who's at home getting ready for his own wedding. He's trying to buy the socks and things like that.
Wishes it's going to be as good as this.
I'd like to mention Katie and all these grandparents, and I'm sure it'll be extremely proud to see them both looking so happy today. Ethel and Bert and Molly, and I don't know all these grandparents' names, so I didn't bother to check. But the video did. For some reason, she was given a list, and I wasn't given a list. I'd like to thank Connie for looking really radiant and for giving me such a beautiful daughter. This is the bit where I start to... I end up on the floor like a bag of rags. Katie's provided us with so much joy and laughter over the years, and we've always been proud of it, and it's great to see her looking absolutely gorgeous today. In the part of my bride's speech, you're supposed to say something very embarrassing about your daughter, you know, and make it cringe and blush. But I've been doing that all her life. So I'm going to give her a break. I'm not going to bother. She's never given us any reason to worry, or she's a perfect young lady. And I'm proud to call her my daughter. I'm sure Ollie will be proud to call her his wife.
Yes.
There's the handkerchief, sir. Ollie, I'd like to take the opportunity to welcome you to our family. During the time Connie and I have known Ollie, we've come to realise how special he is to Kate and what a great son-in-law he's going to be. The first time I realised that Katie and Ollie were an item was when she started asking me how Arsenal were getting home on Saturday afternoon. I wasn't sure, but when she said that, that's it. It's I learned early on, he's never going to be a Liverpool supporter. Yeah, but maybe that's the best. Every time we go to a match together, we lose. I always end up crying. We went to the FA Cup final, Ollie and I. I got tickets for the two of us to go to the FA Cup final this month. And we lost. And Mr. Collins over there will really rub it in later. But that was a good example. He's a good shoulder to cry on, Ollie. Honestly. He didn't take the Vicky, but we lost that. It was good. So, thanks very much, Ollie. Right. It seems like yesterday I resigned my position as position as contracts manager at Tunnel Form Construction, started my own business. Connie was 6 months pregnant. This is important. She was 6 months pregnant. We were in the middle of the worst recession the country's ever seen. And everyone's saying, don't pack your job in. 3 months later, Katie arrived and I had to revise my retirement plans then. This is 30 years ago. I was going to hand over my business to my new son. And then Katie arrived. So we got a new plan. Plan one, get Katie a good education, did that. Send her to university, get a business degree, she did that. Make sure she finds a nice boy to marry so they can take over the business, she did that. Excuse me, it's been going exactly to plan for a while now. Then they took over the wrong business. They took over that paper. Yeah, luckily enough, we have two people who stepped into the breach, and I need to say this. Without who Connie and I would be lost, Damien and Brenda, between them run the business successfully while we're away, or we're taking it easy, or while we're organising, printing wedding stuff, or sorting out wedding plans. I haven't done that. Oops.
Go on.
I haven't done much real work this last couple of weeks. I've been doing very little.
Weeks. Wheat.
Shake it.
Need to shake it.
Shake it like this. Right.
We can hear
you. That's okay.
Jack, darling.
We've been tied up making arrangements for today and having the odd drink in the garden.
Yeah,
with our Canadian cousins. But I must say, it's been a labour of love for me, and I'm looking forward to my role as father of the bride for years, you know. Have you seen the film? I remember saying to Kate, I can't wait to play Steve Martin at your wedding. He sat watching the movie a few times, you know. She didn't listen. She misheard me and thought I said Martin Sheen. So I've been getting text off Ollie all week saying, dear Frank. joking aside, I know how busy you are both in your jobs. The two of you are really interested in your jobs, and but I know how much effort you put into making today so special for all of us.
Yeah.
And you need congratulating for that. Yeah. And I hope today's living up to your expectations. It's living up to mine. Yeah. To close my speech, I'd like to leave you with a little pearl of wisdom. It's a well-known fact that the secret of a successful marriage is patience, tolerance and forgiveness. Mm. Failing that, I can recommend wearing hearing aids that you can switch on. So it's worked for me for years. My final duty and very great privilege is to propose a toast to our daughter and new son-in-law, but to break from tradition, this has got you, I'd like you all to stay in your seats. Everybody sit down. Kate and Ollie will be upstanding, so we can all admire the dress and the suit.
Yes.
Okay. And so, to Kate and Ollie.
Many
many generous gifts you've given us, the vast majority towards our honeymoon in California that we got on Tuesday. I think it's fair to say that we are uber excited about that. So thank you for your extreme generosity. We really genuinely do appreciate it. We can't wait to get stuck into the experiences that await us in the next couple of weeks. I'd like to make a special mention at this stage to Andy and Mark, who very, very kindly for our wedding present gave us videoing our wedding today, despite the fact that they're actually guests here, and they're very good friends of Anna Connie and ours. We really appreciate over the last year or so as we're planning for our wedding, all the expert advice you've given us. Enjoying the cups of tea with you and Lucy the dog in your office, and indulging a bit of voyeurism, watching literally hundreds of other people's wedding videos. Absolutely. Okay, when I first met Katie, I thought she was fun, I thought she was kind, and I thought she was caring. And when I met Alan Connie, I knew exactly where she got it from. It's clearly genetic, and I really hope that our kids inherit that. You've done a fantastic job of raising such an amazing daughter, providing her with a lot of love over the years, making her into the wonderful person that she is today. So I want to thank you for helping her to be her. I want to reassure you that I love Katie all my heart and soul. I do my best every single day to make her as happy for the rest of her life as I know she's going to be. Jesus.
Okay, stop.
I'm going to leave the next screen, please. Seriously, no. On behalf of both of us, I want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for everything you contributed to make today absolutely perfect, and give your princess the fairy tale wedding that she's always wanted. With us down south, and the frost over the other side of Penance, I know it's not been easy for you guys being.
Well, come on.
Give it up.
Project.
We tried to turn it on and off again. Where's the on button? I'll just bell out if I need it to.
Okay, I'm going to buy a new mic for the first one, two. One, two.
Let's find out. Oh, yeah, you can hear it. To be fair,
shout out.
I'm going to try. Where do we get to? We really appreciate you being the only only Northwestern based family. It's been hard for you, relying on you guys so much as we have to to run around Merseyside at the drop of a hat, buying things, paying for things, and making things. That means an awful lot to us. Now, personally, I haven't just gained a wife today, but I've gained a family. And traditionally, at this stage, I'm supposed to thank Alan and Connie for welcoming me into their family, but they've made me feel very welcome and part of their family for many years now. I could not wish for nicer in-laws, and I hope that they're as happy with me as a son-in-law as I am with them as parents in-law. Thank you. This bit's going to be hard, so I'm going to go and bait them off the card. To my mum and dad, a special thank you for all the love and support you've given me over the years. You've got me through thick and thin. You might not think it, but I had my moments growing up. And you were always there to give me guidance and help when I needed it, or just a damn good clip round the ear. Your love and support have made me who I am today, and somebody that Katie deems fit enough to be her husband. And for that, I'm extremely lucky to have such wonderful parents. Thank you for everything you've always done for me. Everything you've done to contribute to making today so perfect, and I hope that you're as proud. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am as you. Thank you. Okay, so we're delighted today, as Alan said, that we officially become one family. So on behalf of my wife and I'd really, really from the bottom of our hearts like to thank both parents for all their love and support in bringing us up, the foundations and opportunities they've given us that we've always had. Today wouldn't be possible without them. For that, we're both infinitely grateful. And for that reason, Katie and I would like to raise a toast to the parents. Parents.
Parents.
There's a change of tradition.
Okay, so today we've had an amazing day so far. Anyone that's got married will know how much time, effort, and preparation is involved, but thankfully we've had some really wonderful people for who we couldn't have done it without. Firstly, I'd like to thank Joanna, Paul and Ellie. You look absolutely fantastic. You've always been there for Katie, loving and supporting her, not only in the build-up to the wedding, in some of her bridezilla moments, but throughout all the years that you've known her. You've been absolutely wonderful. You've added so much to the occasion, and you gave Katie two fantastic hen-do's that I know she won't forget. So on behalf of both of us, we'd like to sincerely thank you for all the love and support you've always given to Katie.
Yeah. We have a toast.
She beat Tony.
You had your toast.
Okay, there's an unwritten rule of wedding etiquette that says that nobody should be more handsome than the groom. So I'd like to thank all the men in the wedding party for sticking to that rule. So that I look the bomb on all the pictures. Seriously though, Rob and Jamie, you did a fantastic job ushering the wedding today and managing my paranoia about the spacing of the seats in the church. You look great. Thank you very much for all your help. We'd also like to thank our godmothers, to Brenda, to Andy, and to Jill. You delivered some great, seamless speeches for us today in the church. It means an awful lot to us that you've known us all our lives, that you were at our christenings, that you supported us growing up, and today you read at our wedding. For that, we're eternally grateful, and thank you for today. Penultimately, I'm glad to hear, this particular part of the day wouldn't be the raving success it is without a few people who are very dear to us, who we asked to host your tables, so that you had a great time. I'm sure you'll agree, they're doing a fantastic job. Okay, finally to the best men, Nick and Will, thank you. I'm truly honoured that you agreed to be my best men. You did a really, really good job of keeping my nerves under control as I bounced off the walls. Organised two great stag do's for me, and you got me to the church on time. Thank you. I know they're quite nervous about delivering their speech in a bit, so feel free to heckle. Okay, closing the thank yous, of course the biggest thank you today has to go to Katie for being so beautiful. I'm on the other first line and nearly lost it. For being so beautiful and for being my wife, I can't tell you, begin to tell you how absolutely stunningly gorgeous you look today. When I turned around and saw you coming down the aisle, I realised that it was definitely me that was getting the best of this deal. Now, it's actually quite rare.